Today I would like to show you how the electrical circuit of the solenoid cannon can look like, which ffleurey modeled for the Gravitrax system. At first I thought it would be okay to apply 5 volts to the solenoid, because that's what the spec says it should be. Unfortunately, however, that is not sufficient by far. Below 25 to 30 volts, it simply lacks the momentum to bridge a meaningful high. At these voltages, however, there is the risk that the coil in the solenoid will melt. After only a few seconds at 28 volts, the solenoid begins to get very hot. That's why only very short current impulses should be sent. Of course, you could solve this with an Arduino or an ESP8266, but actually a very simple circuit is sufficient. To get the voltage of 28 volts from a few AAA or LiPo batteries, the voltage is boosted with a buck converter like the MT3608. In the schematic you can see that the 28 volts is now connected to the normally close of the switch, which charges the 1000 microfarad capacitor when open. When the switch is pressed, the capacitor turns into the current source and connects its positive terminal to the solenoid. The charge is sufficient for a decent pulse. If the switch remains pressed, there is no longer a risk of the solenoid overheating. This is especially important when children play with it. If you like, you can of course upgrade the circuit with an Arduino or ESP8266, for example, to trigger the solenoid via smartphone or automate it. I hope I could help you with my solution. See you next time.
Bits und Bytes, 0 und 1, analog, digital, 8-Bit Laserstrahl, Data, Sette, Donkey Kong, Endboss, Cheat, Commodore, SIP-Chip.